Good morning, dear students. Today we are supposed to talk about the second part of the in continuations with my first lecture what I have given a day before. In the yesterday's lecture we have talked about certain important components right from the psychology, psychiatry, normal structure, functions of human mind, and as well as the important components of personality, the structure of the personality that comprises of id, ego and superego. That particular part we have discussed in detail, and along with that I have shown you a case with an emotional problem and how with the perfect use of the homeopathic case taking as well as the medicine use, the patient got recovered. So a proper medicine was selected on the basis of the typical personality pattern and the correct disturbances by which the patient is suffering, the cause of the ailments, of the problems, we come down to the right simulacrum, and that particular patient recovered well within a day and doing well. Okay, so now we are entering into the another part where we will talk about the different types of personality. Now personality means actually what I am, how I behave, how I act, how I am in the environment. Okay, so basically the personality that got classified into several categories, right from anxious personality, hypomania, hysterical, melancholia, and some other personality. You see that anxious personality, that means this particular personality, grade 2, that is extremely common. As we are intellectually growing, as we are very much connected to our performance, so then you see that what happens, the person usually get a matter of anxiety. Anxiety is what? Anxiety means what I am right in this moment. I want to present myself in the environment on that particular time. I am thinking about that, whether I am doing right, whether I am careful about it, whether I am going to get a good outcome of it. So that is the main concern. And actually whenever we are concerned about that, the future, staying in the present, thinking about the future. So that made us to be very cautious, very careful. And we become restless. If you see a person of anxiety, you see that they are having a typical body gesture, body language, like that of crossed legs. It's a very common phenomenon that you can observe. They are always thinking about that, probably I may go wrong. So they are taking huge precautionary measures. So these are anxiety people. If you see homeopathic drugs, they are also showing some important characteristics, like that of argentum, nitricum, they are with a very typical time anxiety. I may be late. Tomorrow I may come late. So they are starting or they are beginning too early. They are going to this railway station and you have seen that they are looking at the railway track repeatedly. So if the train comes. So this is the simple matter of the anxiety that the person is having with. So this is majority of the people, they are of anxious personality. They are personality type of it. You see that all doctors, engineers, they are usually anxious people. So that's why they are very careful, they are very cautious, and they are taking lot many precautionary measures. Similarly, if you look about the first one, aggressive. In these days, usually see aggressive people numbers are extremely rare. They are basically aggressive people are that whenever you have poor conscience, they are aggressive. They are highly dominating. They behave very rudely. So these people are aggressive. And usually see what happens, this personality people don't like. Nobody likes it. So So this is the matter of an aggressive people. Third, what we have talked about, that means the hypomaniac. Hypomaniac means these people, they are very much careless, frivolous. Like that, they are very much cheerful, joyful. It is, many times usually see in a very serious condition, serious environment, you see that the people laugh at them. Because usually see the behavior is many ways silly. They are not supposed to do like that. Hysterical with a purposive. Hysterical personality is actually a purposive personality. What is that? That to fulfill some of the motives, a person behaves hysterically. See, that hysterical personality, they are exhibitionist. Like that of showing that I am ill. They want to draw the attention of the people. They want to see that the people should attentive to them. They will care about them. They are dramatizing many of the times. And that people are hysterical. There are many people that usually see that visit the doctor off and on, only very small silly things. That doctor, this has happened, this has happened, this has happened, this has happened. And if you see that pathology do not support it. Pathological phenomena of that particular patient, they do not support it. And usually see these people, they are hysterical in their behavior. Melancholia is a typical mood disorder related problem. So where you see melancholia, that in a bad depressive mood, they do not find something very much interesting, something very much joyful, something very much pleasurable in the whole environment. That's why they feel depressed. They are unhappy. And by and large, they are totally pessimistic. By and large. Next important person's personality type is obsessive. Obsession. Obsession means, if you ask the patient that what is your obsession, the patient will explain that I can't help doing that. I have to do it. I need to do it. Like that of hand washing. You see that some people, they were obsession about the hand washing. Washing the hands repeatedly. So feel that something wrong may happen. So that's why. Nowadays you see that we are washing hands repeatedly. To have a joke like that of a few days after, whenever the corona will be over, we may have some obsession of washing our hands. Okay. So this is a very simple matter that the obsession goes about. I have seen a patient that the patient usually see they have purchased eggs from the market. He is very fastidious. What he used to do? The eggs are collected from the market. In home, you know, these eggs are all been kept in soap and water because egg contains some of the seeds of the and other dirty substances. So they are placed in the soap water, then brushed it, wiped it out clearly, and then after some time cracked the egg and have an omelette. So this is very typical about that obsession. Whereas paranoia is totally different. Paranoia means paranoid behavior. Paranoid behavior means, you see that if you just ask your conscience, that you will see that this is not the right way. A human, where you see that they will adjust in the environment, the society, and they are the sophisticated product of the creations. You see that person sees thinking paranoically, means they are giving trouble to the others with a very bad motive or intention. Exactly opposite to the word leave and let leave is not the word, exactly give trouble to the others. They are finding pleasure out of it. This is a very typical and psychopathic type of behavior. You see that they are paranoia. And lastly, you see that psychopathic means they are with a very bad traits. Bad traits means usually see that these traits, that bad traits relates to what? That bad traits relates to the some harm to the society. Creating harm. The environment where I am staying, without understanding that the thing may return back, they are seeing that the total environment gets pointed. Like that of a simple, right from the see that antisocial behavior, like that of in the road, you see, you are not following the disciplines. You are spitting. You are like that of creating some nonsense in the road. You are causing some problems to the others, like that of creating smoke, or like that of you see that you are going to see that the people are
moving around, creating nonsense, and become panic. So these are paranoia behavior, paranoid behavior, like that of you are harassing people for nothing. So these are all paranoia behavior. So these are the common personality pattern, and as I have told you very specifically at the beginning, that anxiety personality, anxious personality are the maximum number of the people they get involved with. They are the common personality pattern.
Then, next you see, I told about that signs of mentally healthy persons. Whenever we talked about that, what are the signs, when you see that the person considered as a mentally healthy. There are some outlines, very simple outlines, like that of the first and foremost duty is that, you know that we are social animals, isn't it? Human is a social animal. So, we have to adjust with the environment, the society, the environment of the, with the family, with all surroundings, we are supposed to behave properly. Darwin properly told about that, if you adapt and adjust yourself in the environment, you will survive. So, what is the very simple way? The person who is mentally healthy, they adjust with the environment. They have a proper degree of the adaptations. Say, for example, if you see that if we find out that the climate is winter. So on that particular winter, what you are supposed to do? You are supposed to have warm clothes. And that is for your comfort. Similarly, for the comfort of your family, you are supposed to purchase some warm clothing for the whole family members. Similarly, if you think about the deeper level, like that of a society, you see that you are a beggar that has no food, and you have ample of food, so you should give some food to the particular person. So this is the normal humanistic behavior, human-like. Like that of this is a time whenever we are taking care of people and the surroundings very much. We are very much concerned about that. This is the way rather we take care of the society, environment. Our every of the phenomena, that like that of a thinking process, that their behavior, okay, the duty that to be performed perfectly, rightly. In a true sense, if you see that what are the signs of a mentally healthy person, your mind guides you that these are all healthy behavior. You need not ask, or you need not read a book, or you need not do it. You ask your conscience, the conscience will give you answer, you should do like that. But if you are paranoid persons, so your paranoid mind will tell in a different way, exactly opposite. So what happens? So they all are dutiful, they all careful about himself, family, society, environment, and do accordingly. In a very perfect way, they see that they take care of the environment. Similarly, the signs of a mentally ill person, they are with mental dysfunctions. They cannot control it, of course. That dysfunction means that abnormal thinking. Thinking which is not there, some delusions, illusions. So these are all the signs of mental dysfunctions. Behavior wise, they are rowdy, they are violent, they are aggressive, they are destructive, they are, these people, they are intolerable by the society. Other persons can decide that this personality is not a good one, and they are intolerable. The people usually see, don't like them. This is the matter. Next point, see phobias, obsession, compulsions, all other features. They are also showing that you cannot balance, you cannot tolerate a degree of strain, stress and strain. And you suffer from various degrees of the phobias. Like that. Nowadays, you see, the environment becomes so dangerous that many people have some various phobias. Like that of, you are going out of the home and you have a phobia, like that of something wrong will happen. And you are not going out. Obsession means, I have already talked about obsession means that repeatedly performing the same thing. Somatic symptoms like that of autonomic nervous system disturbances, like that of various body language and gestures, like that of. Many of the times you see that they are having a very typical body language, like that of, we are calling somebody like that, we should do like this. So a person is taking some hand toward the face, so whenever the person is taking the hand towards the face, so it has a purpose like that, so you want to rub this particular part like. But here the person is doing just like that. So this is something very peculiar that is showing that autonomic disturbances like that. Sometimes usually see like that Jinkam Metallicum patients, you see that there is continuously twitching of the feet and the toes. That is an autonomic disturbance. Clear? So that talks about somatic symptoms. Antisocial behavior, that is another sign. And some brain disturbances, like that really the pathology is inside the brain, like epilepsy. Then how the psychiatric diseases by at large got classified? See that there are basically various ways of classifications. The main important psychiatric diseases are classified according to DSM-4, and another way of classification that we are seeing that organic psychiatric disorders, like really there is some damages, like that of head injuries have taken place and the patient becomes psychiatric patient. Become aggressive, become rude, misbehaving, like. Many of the times substance misuse, like that of opiums, drugs, various drugs, barbiturates. So these are the drugs that causes psychiatric problem. Some of the delusional problems or personality related problems, split heads personality related problems, as you see schizophrenia. Affected and affective mood disorder means mood is affected, like that of Netrambior, if you talk about Netrambior, they are having with a very much depressed mood, self-centered mood, and usually see contradictory. The mood is contradictory to the environment many of the time. Neurotic stress related disorder means that they are excessively reacting or excessively reacting to the environment which is not proportionate to the stimulus. So they are neuropathic behavior, like that of phobias, panic attacks. So they are all neurotics. And some psychological disorders usually see that give rise to behavioral changes by and large. Changes in the behavioral pattern. Behavioral pattern means the behavior got a change. Like that of, you see that paranoid behavior that has taken place after a particular stimulus and after that obsessions, like that of they are disturbances. And lastly, what I talked about, that there are personality type of disorders, the personality got changed, a new environment and a new situation, their personality which was not previously present, that got a degree of somewhat degrees of the changes. So these are the common classifications as you see. Now, the very short outlining how we take the history. This is very, very important. Here it has been shown that the patient who is a 24-year clerk in BA classes, educational qualification up to BA, and parents from this side, if you see this father, he said, and the mother, which got myocardial infarct, so early death of the mother is one of the major reasons whenever the child is not getting the desired amount of the love, approbation, appreciations, etc. Usually see that child may suffer. And other three people, they are married, they are totally, how many? Five people. people are there, five brothers and sisters, that mother died early, and this is the reason she will be affected. This is the way rather you should take the history. How to take the history? Take the history means you have to go and ask born and brought up, the environment, the parental history, what is happening in the family, the diseases prevalent in the history, relationship, interpersonal relationship among them, and what are the stress and strain on which the person has been exposed. And this is rather the basically the trait that has come from this to this, the trait came. And the victim on that type of thing. Now we need to know that what are the reasons, what are the causes. The causes are very specifically limited, like that of heredity is one of the causes. Whenever adolescents come, that there is some changes, the pivotal changes. So, if you don't have desired knowledge, as in country India, this is not usually been very given, sex educations. So, quite naturally, there are lot many ifs and buts, a lot many fear and apprehensions about it. And the people get some problems. Some people get depressed. Some people get phobias. And so on. I've told you already, head injury is one of the major cause of the, because brain and mind, they are inseparable. Inseparable, brain and mind. So quite naturally, head injury is one of the major reasons. Some of the brain-related infections, like that are many of the viral infections, and bacterial infections, parasitic infections, of course. So there are the reasons if we see that brain affected. And some metabolic disorders. Metabolic disorders. You see that, and endocrine disorders, these are two major factors by which the problems come. Like that of diabetes is one of the major reasons. Comas, etc. That come in. And drugs, of course, and alcohol. Most important, you see that this is a condition, so defects. Whenever I know I have a physical defect like that, my mental status, that usually do not remain very good and very much tolerable. I become unhappy. I become depressed. And particularly whenever these people, they are not taken by the surroundings. And even sometimes they are taken so pitifully, like that of the situation goes wrong. So this particular physical defects becomes a stigma, like that I cannot do like this. I have one hand, my hand are disfigured. I cannot move my hand. So this is big deal. And usually majority of them give rise to depressions. And if it is an earlier age, sometimes these people, they become very aggressive. And lastly, which is very important, that strained IPR, interpersonal relationship. So, as on today, we have known the various components of various important that one nomenclature that we need to understand, and a common understanding of the or the factors, common understanding of the factors or influences by which our normal component of the mind, like a personality, like my ideas, etc., get affected and we become a psychological patient. Okay? Thank you.